'Cause I'm TNT. I'm dynamite. TNT. And I'll win that fight. TNT. I'm a power load. TNT. Watch me explode.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to this session of Jimmy's Tips and Tricks Using SolidWorks. My name is Jimmy Barrera, and I'm a SolidWorks Elite Application Engineer. In this session of TNT, I'm going to explore a question that we get a lot from our customers. Many times I go on site and do a customized training, or even during our training courses in Cimquest. A lot of people ask, how do you take a picture, put it in SolidWorks, and use that to trace and create their model? So I'm going to show you how to do that in this session of Tips and Tricks. So to start, make sure that you have the image on your computer, whether you download it or you create your image. From there, the first thing you have to do in order to insert a picture is to open up a sketch. Okay, so I'm in my front plane here, and I go to Tools, Sketch Tools, Sketch Picture. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my desktop. I think I have a picture here of the Batman logo just right there. And what it does, it imports it, and it imports it full size, whatever resolution that picture is, how many ever DPIs it has, that's the size that it imports. So this is pretty big, as you can see. It imports huge, 45 inches by 27 inches here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to size it, and that's the first thing you do here. I want to see if I can bring this down. Let me zoom in here. All right, I'm going to accept this just the way it is. And let's go normal two here. Okay, so how do I know how big or how small to shrink this picture? Here's a nice trick. I'm going to create a center line. This is symmetrical, so this is one way to do it. And I'm going to make the center line the size of the image, the maximum size that I want the image to be. So I'm going to sketch on here. Let's say I want the width of this logo to be 5 inches. So that's what I do. I'm also going to add a relationship. So maybe these two guys, I want to make a midpoint. And now I can double click back into the picture that activates the sketch picture property manager, as you can see here. Now I can take this picture and then just resize it accordingly. So it's worth getting this right, because once you have this right, you no longer have to mess with it. Okay, if you can see here, this is pretty close. I'm going to zoom in just a little more and just kind of tweak it, play with it a little bit back and forth. If you wanted to get this dead on, another thing you can do is you can do the vertical center line, and that way you can make sure that all four points, the cardinal points, are matched up with the picture and the picture's centered on my sketch. So to exit this, I'm going to hit the check mark, and I'm going to go ahead with that suggestion I just gave you. So I'm just going to make a vertical center line, make sure that this is midpoint right on the origin there, and pull this. As you can see, I pull it to the extremes. It's not bad. It's actually pretty good. So I got the external measurement, which is 5 inches to the outside of both sides of this logo. And once I have it just the way I like it, I exit my sketch. What I like to do is I don't like to sketch right on this sketch that has a picture, because what happens sometimes as you're creating your sketch and you're using the same one, you'll accidentally double click on the image and the image will kind of shift on you. And you have to bring it back and it gets real messy. All right, so this is in position. I'm going to start a new sketch now in the front plane and just go about the same steps here in tracing. Now, depending on how you're going to use this, you can use arcs, lines, circles, square, analytical geometry, or you can use splines. With splines, the best quality spline you can create is a two-point spline. So I think a rule of thumb that is good to know is when using splines, the fewer points possible, the better quality spline. So I'm going to click here, I'm going to click here, and notice as I hit escape, I can now click on that line and there's drag handles. There's a diamond, which controls the degree. There's also an arrow that controls the magnitude. And there's a point that controls both. So I'm just taking this extremity here and just mapping it right around this area here. As you can see, very simply, I have a two-point spline, and it does a very nice job in capturing that shape there. Now, what would have happened if I would have used a continuous spline? Click here, and then clicked here. Well, it's going to try to make it into one smooth curve. So if you want a sharp, like at this point right here, then I want to make sure that I use a separate spline for that. And that's what I'm going to do right now. I'm going to use a separate spline, start at this point, and this is going to be my new two-point spline. Hit Escape, and I can take this guy and do exactly the same thing I just did for the other one. I'm following the same steps. It takes a little bit of imagination to understand what the final shape will look like, but as you can see, it does a very nice job in mapping this out. I got this section pretty good there. I'm going to go ahead and grab this section. And again, splines are interpolations, so I'm getting this close. As you can see here, this is close enough. This is just for demonstration purposes. So I'm going to use a couple more splines. I'm going to do this rather quickly. Notice that splines also do have a property that if I move this, I can take this specific side of the spline and just click horizontal. All right, this is pretty good. This is going to ensure I have a nice continuous arc after I mirror it, and there is no sharp point here once I'm done. Okay, so I like the result. As you can see, it mapped it around pretty good. So I'm going to go ahead and close this off. I'm going to build the shape first and then mirror it. So I'm going to go from here to here. There you go. So I'm going to go ahead and extrude this. Does a nice job, as you can see. I'm going to go something noticeable, 0.25. And look how easy that was. I brought in the picture. I sized it. I went ahead and put the overall dimensions. And now I trace it. And now it's pretty easy in SolidWorks, right? The next step is go here and then go to my mirror function. I'm going to mirror that whole body. And there you go. You have your Batman shape. Now, what's nice about putting this sketch picture separate, I can go here and hide this. And notice what stands out is just the shape itself. So as you can see, importing a picture into SolidWorks and tracing it, creating a solid model out of it, it goes pretty quickly. And hopefully this video has been helpful for you guys. And that's pretty much it for this session of Jimmy's Tips and Tricks Using SolidWorks. And we'll see you next time. Take care.